We are in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning, GoProvidence.com, Chef Jeremy Ewing-Chow, Russell Morin Fine Catering. We are making Salt Block Hibachi Beef. This is the salt block,
just yes,
so we
is.
Get that started.
Yep.
This is how we're actually going to cook the beef later on, correct?
Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly.
Let's get to the ingredients to see what we have.
Well, we have two main components. First off is the beef. This is a flat iron steak. It's kind of considered the second most tender cut of meat, second only to the tenderloin.
Okay.
It has a lot of the intramuscular fat, really flavorful, really tender, and much less expensive.
Right, I was going to say, you said it was much less expensive.
Yep.
Okay.
Going with the seared beef that we're going to be doing on the salt block, we're going to do a shiitake mushroom and grilled onion salad with a miso vinaigrette. So it's going to be a really quick, simple presentation. It's going to have a lot of different flavors.
Right. And these two things will be prepared beforehand, correct?
Right.
Because
right.
only the beef will be cooked on this, correct?
Yeah, you could grill all this stuff on the salt block itself, but you know, I kind of like the flavor that you get from an actual hardwood grill.
Okay.
With the mushrooms, but you could also broil them, you could just saute them. But you know, I like kind of that smokiness that you get
flavor.
From the grill.
Okay, what else
Absolutely.
We have over here?
These are just the components that are going to be going into the miso vinaigrette. We got miso paste, which is a fermented soybean paste.
Mm-hmm.
It's the main flavor in miso soup.
Okay.
We get some ginger, toasted sesames, the shiitake mushrooms, obviously, sesame oil, soy sauce, and this is a yuzu juice.
Oh, all right.
A yuzu is a Japanese citrus fruit. It's mainly used more for its juice as opposed to like an orange that you would eat.
Right.
You know, it's usually done more in juice and in things like marmalades.
Okay.
So it has like a balanced flavor between, you know, it's not as tart as a lime,
right.
but it's not as sweet as an orange. It kind of
okay.
has its
very
own
good.
Own different flavor
All right,
profile.
We have our ingredients set to go. We're going to get cooking in on the salt block very shortly. In the meantime, back to you.
Back in the kitchen. How's it going, Michaela?
Oh, it's great. We're going to get things going now with Chef Jeremy from Russell Morin Fine Catering. And I have to say, Will, Mary, and myself were at the Children's Museum Gala, and you guys were catering that. The food was delicious.
Excellent.
We all loved it, but we want to focus on the dish that we're making today. So what's our step that we're learning now?
Well, one of the items we have are our shiitake mushrooms.
Okay.
So I'm just going to show you how to kind of pluck out the stem. You know, the stems on shiitake mushrooms especially are really woody.
Uh-huh.
So what you want to do is you kind of hold all the way around the base of the stem
okay.
to support the mushroom, and then you just pull out. So you can see how this
stem. Oh, okay.
Just pop it
right
off.
I was going to break the whole thing.
So just pop right off.
So this is how we're going to prep
yep.
the mushrooms. And you've already cooked a few of them,
yep.
right?
Yeah, what I did is I did this step. I marinated them in some of the miso vinaigrette that I spoke about before. And then now we're just going to slice them up. So you can just take them, you know, kind of stack up three or four at a time.
Okay.
And then just
just slicing them
yep,
across.
Yep, yep. Slice them kind of thin.
Oh,
you know,
gosh.
We would call it a julienne.
Julienne. I'll call it a Michaela.
Okay. It's still pretty.
Excellent. Okay. So chop those up. And what are we
yep.
going to use these for? As a side to
this,
the dish?
Yep.
Or?
And it's also going to go with these the green onions.
Okay.
Yeah, the green onions. You know, as you know, like the base of the green onion
mm-hmm.
is a lot thicker than the top. So I cut them in half, and I pre-grilled these ahead of time. The reason why I cut them in half is because this the base of the green onion being thicker is going to take a little bit longer to cook on the grill than these than the top greens.
Okay.
You know, putting them on the grill just kind of gives it, you know, that nice smoky flavor. That's going to be a really nice complement to the flavor of the beef.
Excellent.
So we're gonna chop all these up.
Mm-hmm.
We're gonna combine these with the miso vinaigrette.
Yum.
That has the yuzu juice, the soy sauce, some sesame oil, a little bit of toasted sesame seeds
mm-hmm.
for a little bit of crunch. We're going to make that into a salad.
Perfect.
We're going to plate that with the seared beef that we're going to season up with some Maldon sea salt
All
mixed
right.
with some Szechuan peppercorns and citrus zest.
It sounds delicious. We're going to finish it all up a little later in the show. Back to you. Back in the Rhode Show kitchen with GoProvidence.com, cooking with Chef Jeremy Ewing-Chow from Russell Morin Fine Catering. We are making up a great beef dish, and we're cooking on something very interesting.
Yep, it's a Himalayan salt block.
Okay.
Obviously, as the name implies, they're mined from the Himalayan mountains. The salt block deposits themselves are somewhere around 200 million years old.
Wow.
As you can tell, they come from really big, thick deposits, and they cut these big, thick slabs.
Okay.
The big thick ones like this are the ones that you can use to cook on because they'll absorb a lot more heat, they'll
mm-hmm.
hold a lot more heat, and a lot more conducive to cooking. There's also smaller ones you can have more for like a display.
Mm-hmm.
They're a little bit thinner.
Yeah, a lot smaller than this one here. And you were talking about before too, the meat that you put on here should be kind of minimally marinated.
Right, because you don't want to have the more liquid or the wetter your product is, mm-hmm. then the more salt is going to get into the meat
okay.
from the salt block.
Mm-hmm.
So if you start with, so in other words, if you're using beef like we are now, or tuna or scallops, you don't want to use a marinade. You just want to use like a rub or, just a little bit of salt and pepper.
Okay.
You still do want to season it with a little bit of salt.
All right, yeah. What are you using to season too? Because that's an interesting mixture.
Right, what I have here is... the salt itself is Maldon sea salt.
Okay.
Maldon sea salt, it has really big crystals.
Mm-hmm.
And I just mixed it with some crushed up Szechuan peppercorns, some regular
cake.
Peppercorns, and also some citrus zest.
Great.
The best way to get the citrus zest is mm-hmm. These little things called the microplanes. You see them in all the stores nowadays.
Yep.
They're perfect for getting the really fine bits of zest off the top of your orange or grapefruit, lime.
Good
whatever
flavor
you want to use.
Too, from that.
And fantastic flavor.
And let's talk about the cooking. About how long are we cooking these for? We do have to flip them, of course.
Right. Thin piece of meat like this is probably going to be about maybe 2, maybe 3 minutes on the first side. You know, mm-hmm. on the first side, it's going to take a little bit longer because you want to get more of that nice caramelization.
Yep.
And then we're just going to flip it over just for another maybe minute or so just to kind of cook it through just a little bit more.
Excellent.
With this type of meat, we're going to do it to like a medium rare, so it's
okay.
still nice and juicy.
Yeah,
but obviously,
excellent.
If you like your, cooked a little bit more, then just keep it on the stove a little
mm-hmm.
bit longer.
And you have some here that you did finish, that just finished up a second ago.
Yep.
But talk about, too, some of the benefits of using something like a salt block.
Well, the Himalayan...
Why do you prefer that over a, regular skillet or something?
Well, it's more for the aesthetics.
Mm-hmm.
It's really something...
It is very interesting.
Both for the home cook, they definitely sell blocks you can cook on that are a lot smaller.
Mm-hmm.
If someone is, the home culinarian,
yep.
you can definitely buy ones that are, a lot easier to use at home.
Yeah.
And it's more just for the whole... it's definitely something different, especially
yep.
being with Russell Morin Catering. We like mm-hmm. to kind of be at the forefront of...
Put on
new catering trends.
While you're cooking,
exactly.
Right?
People have seen all the different stations. Risotto bars,
mm-hmm.
Pasta bars, paella stations, things
but
like that.
This is unique.
And this is just something new and different. By no means are we the first people to ever do it, but I think we're the first ones on the Rhode Show.
Definitely, so. Definitely. And talk about too how you're taking the temperature of that. We're playing
yep.
our own version of laser tag.
Right.
That's how it's reading the temperature
yep,
of the salt
yep.
block.
It's just a thermal thermometer. It'll uh-huh. just take the surface temperature. It just takes
Whoa.
The guesswork out of it, instead of having to, hold your hand next to it.
Yeah, I'm not going to put my hand
no.
close to that. I don't want to chance it. All right, well, I am going to give this a try. It looks delicious. And again, we've paired that with our little
yep.
Mushroom side dish that we made earlier. Don't forget, you can find all these recipes and more on our website, WPRI.com.